Now, sometimes when we're programming, we might formulate some equation or algorithm in one way, but we may find that it's necessary to reformulate that expression for purposes of simplicity or code clarity. As long as both the expressions are logically equivalent, there's no reason not to do so if it makes our code more easy to follow. There are two useful principles we'll look at next that will help us in this regard: De Morgan's laws and the negation of expressions. De Morgan's laws are a pair of logical equivalences from Boolean logic, which tell us that if we have some logical expression that resembles one of these forms, we can transform that expression into a potentially simpler but logically equivalent form. Here, A and B represent some generalized single conditional expression. So to use these to find the equivalent logical expression, we would simply change any interior AND operator to an OR operator, or any OR operator to an AND operator, distribute or group the NOT operator as shown, and then negate each individual operand expression as needed. This principle is a bit abstract as described here, so we'll take a look at an example of this in a moment. The other principle we cited was the negation of expressions, which simply means the everything else. In this table, we have two operands A and B, and conditional expressions involving all six of the equality and relational operators. The NOT, or negative of any expression on the left side, is shown on the right-hand side as being the opposite, or the everything else. So for example, if A equals B, then the negative of that expression is the everything else, or A not equal to B. If A is less than B, the negative of that, or the everything else, would be A greater than or equal to B. But if A is less than or equal to B, the negative of that, the everything else, would be A greater than B, but not equal to B. Take a few moments now to pause this video and go through these six cases and convince yourself of the validity of their corresponding negative expressions. Here's an example of simplifying an expression into something logically equivalent by using De Morgan's laws and negation. Let's say we start with this expression involving an age check. By De Morgan's laws, we can simplify this expression by doing two things: turning this interior AND into an OR, and distributing this negation operator across both of the individual operand terms. Next, by the negation of expressions, we can simplify each of these terms by negating it. So if the age is greater than 18, the negative of that, the everything else, becomes age less than or equal to 18. Similarly, if the age is less than 65, the negative of that, again, the everything else, becomes age greater than or equal to 65. And so then this becomes our simplified expression. Now granted, we probably could have come up with this on our own with a little bit of trial and error, but De Morgan's laws and negation of expressions, taken together, provide us with a systematic way of transforming more complicated logical expressions into simpler, logically equivalent ones, and this in turn can help the readability or maintainability of our code. In prior lecture materials, we discussed the concept of precedence, which tells us which operators will be evaluated ahead of which other operators in the absence of any explicit guidance in the form of parentheses. We saw this earlier with arithmetic operators, but now we have an additional 9 conditional operators to add to that list. You can find an updated precedence table, which has the complete list of rules, in a couple places. For example, Appendix B in your textbook, if you have it, contains a full list of operator precedence. You can also find the comparable table on Oracle's website, which is linked in this week's lecture materials and given on the next slide. Once again, I offer you the same general guidance on precedence. First of all, know how to interpret the rules of precedence, because existing code you may be working with might be tersely written such that you'll have to untangle the order of operations yourself. But in any new code that you write, don't fall back upon the rules of precedence, but rather be explicit as to what your intentions are, using visual grouping and liberal use of parentheses. If you know what you meant your code to do, don't make the rest of the world figure it out each time. Make your intentions clearly known in your own code. Finally, here's that updated precedence table we just spoke of. This one is from Oracle's JavaTrail set of tutorials, and the URL is also included in this week's lecture materials. For clarity, I've highlighted the 9 additional conditional operators we've considered in this lecture video. Note that they all have their own places in the pecking order, some at higher precedence than others. In particular, Note that the relational and equality operators have lower precedence than the standard arithmetic operators, which means that any arithmetic expressions will be evaluated first before any such comparisons are made, in the absence of any explicit intentions using parentheses. Also, note that the logical and OR operators have lower precedence still than the relational and equality operators, which means that more atomic logical comparisons involving these operators will be evaluated first before such Boolean results are evaluated as part of larger expressions involving these two operators. And lastly, notice that the unary negation operator has higher precedence than any of these others, so it will always get to be evaluated before these other ones. Okay, and with that, we will conclude this discussion of conditional operators. Now that we've seen how to formulate logical expressions which can make true-false decisions, the next step will be to put these conditions to use in selection and looping.